Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. The Lord is good. I'm glad to come your way once again. We will be ending the series of the perspective on leadership today by looking critically to some point about how to relate with your spouse senior, how to relate with your senior leader spouse, how to relate with your senior leader spouse. Especially, I will be talking to men today, church workers, male church workers. Because if you don't know how to relate with your senior leader spouse, you might enter into a whole lot of errors, a whole lot of mistakes. But you just need to listen to me, my own perspective, my own view about how to go about it. Let us go. There is a scripture I want us to look at this very afternoon in Genesis chapter 39, verse 9 and 12. Genesis chapter 39, verse 9 and 12. There is none greater in this house than I. Neither had he kept back anything from me but thee, because thou art his wife. How then can I do this great wickedness and sin against God? And she caught him by his garment, saying, lie with me. And he left his garment in her hand and fled and got him out. Now that is a story about Joseph in the house of his master, in the house of his, we can also use the house of his pastor, his house of his boss, his house of his leader. And he was face to face with temptation to what? To abuse, to sexually abuse the leader's wife. Now, Joseph was able to handle that situation critically by one emphasis in the Bible. He said what? He was able to what? Give a profound statement, because thou art his wife. You must be able to separate your role as a church worker from your leader's wife. Number one point I want us to check this very afternoon, how to relate with your pastor's wife, your leader's wife. Number one, the spouse must be honored. Your pastor's wife must be honored. What do I mean by that? Do not put too much expectations on her. Why? Because regardless of the church size, she cannot be everywhere at every time and know everyone's name and family. Why? And still carry out her role in the family. You need to learn to honor her, because she can't be everywhere at the same time as a leader's wife. You need to check it, your relationship with her, because she is carrying a greater burden with the man of God at home. Number two point, the spouse must be known of any, the spouse must be in the know of any communication and decision reached. For example, now when there are issues that are happening in the department, I think the pastor's wife should be carried along so that there won't be a misnomer in operation in the church workforce. Why? Because the pastor can give an instruction. The pastor's wife, without knowing what has happened, can come and what? Change that same instruction that was given, because there is what? Break in communication. There is no link in communication. So therefore, you as a church worker, you have to do everything possible to communicate also your duty to the pastor's wife when the need arises. Do not expect her to oppose her husband. Do not expect her to oppose her husband. So therefore, now, when you are discussing some critical issues, there are some certain things you must not say to a pastor's wife, to your leader's wife, because you should never expect your pastor's wife to what? To oppose the husband's decisions in the public. She can never do it. Maintain a proper boundaries when relating with your leader's wife. You must learn how to maintain a proper boundaries. You must learn to set the limit. You must learn to set the boundary where your communication starts and where your communication ends. If any of these areas need are adjusted, communication openly and honestly about them. For example, if there is any form of adjustment in the decision reached in any department, you must, as the head of that department, as a member of that department, you must be able to relate with the pastor's wife. Another point I am giving you this very afternoon: protect her from gossip. You must learn to protect your senior leaders from gossip. Then say, it's not proper to be discussed with your senior leader's spouse. Check your motive. If you must discuss anything with your senior leader's spouse, you must check your motives in what you share with her. Don't share what you don't have permission to share. Don't share what you don't have permission to share. What am I saying? For example, somebody discussed some certain things with you. If you are not permitted to share it, if you are not permitted to discuss it with your pastor's with your pastor's spouse, with your leader's spouse, you should keep it between you and the sharer of that issue with you. Help her protect her family. Another point you need to do to help your pastor's spouse, to help your man of God's spouse, to help your man of God's wife, to help her, to help the husband, your pastor, you must learn to help her to protect her family. What am I saying? There are times you should be able to draw the line to know when your pastor is at home and when your pastor is in the office, because there are some decisions that needs to be discussed. There are discussions that needs to be discussed in the office, and there are discussions that need to be discussed at home. Your pastor is still human. Your senior leader is still human. After spiritual activities in church, he need to come back home to have a private talk, a private relationship with the family. So therefore, send an email rather than calling at home. If it is not an immediate concern, send a text message. If it is not an immediate concern, send an email. Why? Because by so doing, you will eliminate distraction between husband and wife. Am I talking to somebody this very afternoon? The spouse must be in the know of any communication and decision reached. I'll talk about that. Now, let us quickly go further to the point. Let's go a bit further to the point. Praise the Lord. You must learn to what? Encourage her. Encourage her to help the husband fulfill the work of the ministry. You must learn to carry this thing into operation, because by so doing, you are helping your leader's wife to help the husband to do the work of the ministry. Praise the living God. Now, let us quickly go a bit further. Do not expect your pastor's wife to always be the one giving the decisions at every given time. Why? Because there are limits to every decision that your pastor can do. There must be a classification of role of the spouse. There must be what? A classification of role of the spouse. You should be able to know what are her duties. What are her duties to do? And what are not her duties to do as a pastor wife? By so doing, you will learn to relate with her. Even if the pastor's wife happens to share personal information with you about the church or her life, keep it to yourself. Keep it to yourself. You should learn to keep secrets. Never repeat what she says without her permission. Never repeat what she says without her permission. Never should you do it. Why? Because it breaks the morale. It breaks the defense of your pastor wife. Am I talking to somebody? Your pastor's wife must be. Your pastor's wife must be a spiritual mother to you. So by so doing, you are happy to curtail every excesses from every other members in the group. Praise the living God. I pray that this very season, as you relate with your pastor's wife, your leader's wife, to do the work of the ministry, your life will change tremendously in the mighty name of Jesus. You will not be defeated in the mighty name of Jesus. Do not expect her at all whatsoever to be in the same clique with everybody in church. Yes, it's good to relate. It's good to associate with people. But we should be able to know that this is a pastor wife. And the same honor that you are giving to a pastor, to that leader, should also be accorded to your pastor or to your leader's wife. Hello, am I talking to somebody? You remember there is a scripture I will quickly read to you about Haman. Haman, you remember in Esther chapter 7, verse 7. And the king, arising from the banquet of wine in his wrath, went into the palace garden, and Haman stood up to make request for his life to Esther the queen, for he saw that there was evil determined against him by the king. Then the king returned out of the palace garden into the place of the banquet of wine, and Haman was falling upon the bed. You see, Haman was not able to set the boundaries between the wife of the leader and the leader. Haman was found in the bed of Queen Esther. Listen to me. You must be able to set the boundary at all times. Don't treat your pastor's wife as if he's one of the ordinary people out there. No, your pastor's wife is also as anointed as your pastor, irrespective of a spirituality. Am I talking to somebody this evening, this afternoon? Then said the king, will he force the queen also before me in the house? As the word went out of the king's mouth, they covered Haman's face. It was not the plot of Haman that killed Haman. It was the lack of setting boundaries between Haman and the king's wife that killed Haman. Listen, there is danger when you don't know how to set the boundary between the work given and the spouse of your leader. I'm talking to somebody this very afternoon. Maintain proper boundary. You must learn to maintain proper boundary. You must learn to do what? Maintain proper boundary. Praise the living God. The Lord bless you this very afternoon as you listen to me, as you take this word to heart. And I pray that your life will change tremendously in the mighty name of Jesus. Subsequently, we will be dealing with another topic, and I will be bringing that topic your way. You should wait to listen. You will check my Facebook, and I will be announcing that top that series that will be taking starting from tomorrow. May the Lord bless you. May the Lord keep you. May the Lord cause his face to shine on you this very day in the mighty name of Jesus. Stay blessed in Jesus' name. I still remain Pastor Constance Samson Bongrate, the host pastor of World Assembly Faith House, Ebute Ikorodu, Lagos. Stay blessed in Jesus' name.